Lord, send that in thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me and I will answer you, and I will lead back your captives from every place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I welcome you to Mass in this Thursday, in the 33rd week in ordinary time. And we're offering our Mass for the good state of Geraldine Burke. I'm going to say something that I might be incorrect on. Today is also the optional memorial of Elizabeth of Hungary. And if I'm right, because Sarah was educating me, she's up there, isn't she?
She is, perhaps.
With the roses.
She's the bell on the far right,
maybe. Yes.
When the window shines.
She was taking bread to the poor, and her husband didn't like it. And so when she was stopped, instead of the bread falling out, they turned into roses. And so there she is, she's up there. So we ask for her intercession also today, Elizabeth of Hungary. If anyone knows why the Rosminians loved Elizabeth of Hungary enough to put her on the back wall, ask for it on the postcard.
Patron saint of Christian charities.
And then the Institute of Charity. There we are. Institute of Charity, she's a patron saint of charity. So that's a good enough answer to me. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my words. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for the peace of the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Your
Lord,
have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, in the Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Bought men for God of every race, language, people, and nation.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus drew near Jerusalem and came in sight of the city, he shed tears over it and said, "If you, in your turn, had only understood on this day the message of peace, but alas, it is hidden from your eyes. Yes, a time is coming when your enemies will raise fortifications all round you, when they will encircle you and hem you in on every side. They will dash your children inside your walls to the ground. They will leave not one stone standing on another within you, and all because you did not recognize your opportunity when God affords it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
Through the Holy Gospel, Christ unrolls the scroll containing God's plan for humanity. As such, Jesus Christ is worthy to be praised. And in doing so, the last days have begun. And so we prepare ourselves for our definitive encounter with Christ at our personal judgment. Everyone should know what is in the scroll. And so all the baptized have a prophetic charism to tell their families and friends of the joy of the gospel, telling the wider community that Christ has conquered our death, that by his cross and resurrection he has redeemed the world. He is the saviour of the world. In the incarnation, God shows the depth of his love. The Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us, full of grace and truth. And Christ's death and resurrection confirms this love for us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. And the Lamb reminds us clearly of the Passover, the blood of the Lamb smeared on the door frames to show the avenging angel not to inflict God's punishment on the Israelites. Now in the most holy Eucharist, the body and blood of the Paschal Lamb enters under our own roof as a sign of protection for our soul. Christ our Lord bore our sins in his body on the tree, that we might die to sin and live to righteousness. It is then a contradiction for us to receive the Eucharist in a sinful state, and so we should be dealing with our serious sins in confession before coming to Holy Communion. And living in a state of grace is possible, for the Church has received the fullness of the Spirit, and in baptism and confirmation, the sanctifying grace we receive helps us avoid God's punishment, but much more importantly, allows us to become saints. The strength of the community, united in its praise of Christ, is also a great help to us on our pilgrimage. By the shedding of his blood, Christ has won for himself an immense people, a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a people set apart to sing a new song of adoration. We must not, however, take any of this for granted. Jesus weeps over Jerusalem, knowing that the city and her people will fall from grace as they fail to recognize the arrival of the Messiah, and they close the gates of their hearts to him. Our Lord Jesus Christ visits each and every one of us. We must recognize him for who he is. He comes to us as Savior. He teaches us by the preaching of the Church. Pray then that we may have the strength to accept his forgiveness and his peace, now and for eternity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, who through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, that it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, through the divine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be your Lord.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant, O Lord, we pray that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Keep your hearts
with the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, you may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world to bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
The same. teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us all, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, but not in our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
you. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. To be near God is my happiness, to place my hope in God the Lord.
The body of Christ.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this secret mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So there's Mass here tomorrow, as usual, at 10 a.m, followed by Adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, and Adoration once again at 7:30 in the evening. On Saturday, please remember that the 10 a.m. Mass will be at St. Martha's, not St. Mary Magdalene this week. It's the parish bereavement.